In the last few years, we have witnessed smartphones have completely destroyed the compact camera market. That is completely expected. Most people like ease of use of smartphones. It is very easy to share images, post them on Facebook and so on. But still, there are a lot of people who want better and higher image quality than a typical smartphone can produce, and they also want optical zoom. In such cases, cameras like this, Panasonic Lumix TZ100, is one of the cameras you should consider. This camera has a big 1-inch sensor, the same one used in Sony RX100 cameras, but on Panasonic it is paired to a big 10x optical zoom, which covers a range from 25 to 250mm. This camera also records video in 4K resolution, it has touch screen and a lot of other advanced options. Build quality of this camera is on a high level. You can see all the buttons and dials have a good tactile feel. But one thing I didn't find very nice is the fact the front part of the camera is not covered with rubber, as is the case with thumb rest. So it would be very smart to have this camera all the time on a strap like this, because there is a chance you might drop it, the camera outside materials are slippery. As I said before, this camera uses a relatively big 1-inch sensor. The larger the sensor, the higher the image quality in most cases. Native ISO range goes from ISO 125 up to 12,800. Image quality is as expected on very high level. You can see images have a very high level of detail preserved in them. Most similar cameras which have smaller sensor than this one do not have that amount of details preserved in images. The lens has 10x optical zoom, it covers from 25 to 250mm. This is very useful, but since the camera is relatively small and the sensor is big, aperture on the lens goes only from 2.8 on wide angle to 5.9 on maximum telephoto. That means you won't be able to use this camera as effectively in low light conditions. You can control this zoom using the dial around the lens, or you can control it using this rocker dial or around the shutter button. Of course, the function of both dials can be customized. On the back you can see 3-inch LCD screen, it has 1.2 million dots and is very detailed and bright. Sadly, you cannot tilt this LCD, so no selfies on this camera, sorry guys. This LCD has touch capability, it works very nice, you can adjust any setting in the menu system or you can touch the part of the frame and focus on that part of the frame. Above the LCD you can see a small electronic viewfinder. In my opinion, this is the worst part of this camera. Electronic viewfinder is extremely small, it has a very low resolution and it suffers from RGB tearing. That means when you move your eyeball and look through viewfinder, you can see small rainbows inside it. For comparison, the most similar camera to TZ100 is Sony RX100. Mark III and Mark IV have much more usable electronic viewfinders, significantly better than Panasonic. This camera also has a small pop-up flash. It is strong enough for typical family usage. Video quality from Panasonic TZ400 is splendid. As I said, it records in maximum resolution of 4K. That is very high resolution. Videos are extremely detailed with very nice colors. One thing to keep in mind is when you record in 4K video, the camera does not use the full sensor surface. It uses only the smaller area in the center, which means you cannot get the same field of view as you would get when taking images. For still photo, this camera has equivalent of 25 to 250mm, but when you record in 4K video, it only covers from 37 to 370mm. If you drop resolution from 4K to Full HD, you can use the lens from 31 to 310mm. This is not maybe the reason not to buy this camera, but if you intend to shoot a lot of videos and if you wanted to shoot video at wide angle, forget it. This camera will not be able to provide it. One of the novelties of this camera is post-focus function. It works the same way as 4K photo mode works. I explained that already in last year in FZ300 review, but the post-focus is the new feature. The thing is, the camera records 4K video by focusing on everything in the frame. And later, when you play back that video, you can take a still image from the video with a focus point on the place that you choose to be at. This is very interesting if you need to shoot, for example, macro images. If you take a classic macro image and the camera misfocuses, you lost the image. Using 4K post-focus mode, you can take sharp images of everything that's in the frame and later choose the one that you like most. On the bottom of the camera you can see a battery compartment. This camera uses a lithium battery. It is strong enough for around 300 shots from a single charge. In the same compartment there is memory card. One thing to keep in mind is you need to buy a memory card that is ultra high speed free or faster. That is because of 4K video. If you buy the slower card, the camera won't be able to record 4K. On the right side you can see connectors. Panasonic TZ100 has micro HDMI output for connecting it to LCD screen, and it also has micro USB, which is used for charging and also connecting to PC to transfer images and photos. Since this is of course 2016, this camera has a built-in Wi-Fi for connectivity to smartphones or tablets. For conclusion, I can say I'm pretty satisfied with TZ100. It has excellent image quality thanks to a large 1-inch sensor. It has very useful optical zoom 10 times. This camera is most interesting to people who travel a lot. That's why it is named TZ100, Travel Zoom 100. Beside the high image quality, this camera also has a very good 4K video mode. It is very easy to use. You can leave it just in full auto mode, and it also has all the manual controls if you are an advanced user. Altogether, great job, Panasonic. That's about it for this review. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and thanks for watching.